Okay, so we have a very hard case here, very heavy duty case. Keep the tool protected. It's a valuable tool. We want to keep it protected. Some soft foam on the top, some high density foam on the bottom. We have a spare battery. We have a charger, and we have the plug in for the charger. Now we have some adapters here. If you live outside of North America, these adapters are for different receptacles and whatnot. And this here is your instructions. Let's take some readings and some images. This video is brought to you by Harago.com, a trades-only platform helping you find the right job or the right candidate. Harago.com, best in trade. First thing we want to do is open up the camera lens, and we do that just by moving the little tab at the bottom here, and that opens up the lens. And if we flip it around, we now view what is in front of the camera, and we can see that soft foam there. To take a picture, snapshot, it's very easy. We pull the trigger, that takes a snapshot. We can see the battery light is flashing there. It needs to be charged, no big deal, but we can still demo the rest of this tool on this low battery. To go back into your pictures that you've taken, it's very easy. We just hit this play button and we see a list of pictures come up right there. So they've made this tool super easy to navigate. So we hit this middle button here. We can see the settings come up right there, and we can scroll image mode, measurement, color, and temperature scale. So if we go back to settings, device settings, one of the cool things we can do in device settings is we can go to Wi-Fi. We can look for networks, and if you can connect your phone and the tool to the same network, what you can do is you can sync the tool to the app, the FLIR Tools app, and then you can transfer the images from the tool straight to your phone. Okay, so we're on a roof here. We got a bunch of rooftops. We got some snow on the ground. So I'm gonna show you what the view looks like from the FLIR E8 XT. So there's the rooftops there, and you can see that right there where the crosshairs is, that is the warmest spot of the rooftop. That is where the fan motor is. So that's where most of the heat is coming from. And we can see all of them there quite clearly, and the difference in temperature. So I have some readings that I've taken on some jobs and some images I've taken. I'm gonna go and show you those right now. We have a Daikin mini split here. Some insulation issues, what we'll have to rectify. But if we look through the tool's eye, we can see the hot and cold spots. And what I found interesting about this one is that we can see where the condenser is warm and where the condenser is cool. The top portion of the condenser is warm and the bottom section is cool, which is very interesting to me. So this is a pretty cool one. This is a two-stage heating unit. Okay, and the venter motor is running for both, but we only have one stage fired. The first stage here, the second stage here is not fired. If we look through the FLIR, we can see that night and day. Very cool stuff. So this is a pretty cool one, guys. We've got a condensing unit up and running with a Vitzer compressor in it. And we use the FLIR and we see where all the heat is. Now here's the filter dryer. We find plug filter dryers by checking the temperature difference across them. Now how easy is it just to shine the tool on there, very quickly diagnose that problem if we were having it. Okay, so now the water is boiling inside, but the surface of the tank is obviously going to be a little bit cooler than the water inside. So we're showing about 183 degrees. And if we pan over to the header where the steam comes out, that is now glowing orange. And we can see a light glow right above it there. It's a little bit cooler than the pipe itself because it's cooling as it leaks. So we're up and running. This is working. Everything's good to go. All right, so I just finished up replacing this fan motor on this Lennox unit heater. My hands are filthy because it's kind of dirty up here. But I wanted to show you the FLIR E8 and just take a couple snapshots of the heat exchanger and behind the fan motor. And the way we do that is we just take the trigger and we pull it. We can get a snapshot of the burner. And just to show you guys in relative terms, the temperature difference between here and something like the dock door. Well, that deep purple there is actually the air infiltration coming from outside around that dock door. So we want to make sure when we're done, we're going to close this lens back off. We're going to put this back into the case, keep it nice and protected with all its parts. Now, this thing here is incredible for troubleshooting, for checking different things like infiltration of air coming into a home or a building, electrical panels, anything that generates heat. That's it, guys. That's the FLIR E8 XT. Hope you enjoyed the video. Happy HVACing.